Hi, survivors. This is me, Prepper Zan, reporting to you again. I'm talking about how an emergency plan needs to be set in place these days and times. We should always have a backup plan, an emergency plan. So many people are being displaced from out of their homes due to these weather-related events, these floods and these disasters just occurring all of a sudden, and also behind maybe, God forbid, fires, or you know what happened out there in Florida with a building collapsing. It's so much stuff that's going on nowadays. It's just all of a sudden happening. I know a lot of people cannot afford to have another home, or maybe money for hotels or whatever the place is. But if you have vehicles, keep your vehicles ready. A lot of people are living in their vehicles these days and times just to have a place to stay, because a lot of people have lost their homes from, you know, just the PLANDEMIC, losing their jobs, losing their businesses, you know, income, or from, you know, getting sick and whatnot, and not being able to work. So it would behoove us to just have a plan set in place, whether it be just have a little bit more food that you can eat, that you set aside, a little bit more money and savings if you can do so, even if it's $100, even if it's $50, $200, whatever you can, because things are just happening. I had two emergencies to occur back to back all of a sudden in 1 week. When I tell you guys, it took so much money for me, so much time. I am exhausted. I don't want to get into what happened, but it's just been back to back situations. And then with dealing with the crime in the cities and all these types of things, you never know, something might happen where you live, and you might have to just all of a sudden leave. You know, try to have some kind of plan in place already where you know where you can go, whether it be to a friend's house, a neighbor house, or out of town. You know, have money set aside to, if you have to leave your city. A lot of people are faced with these types of situations right now, and a lot of them didn't expect it. The thing that happened out there in Florida, a lot of those people lost everything. Those people who were able to survive, they lost everything that was in their apartment, in their condo, you know, from their personal items. Make backup copies of your personal information, of your important documents, like your ID, your social security card, your passports, your birth certificates, you know, different documents that you may need, your insurance policies. Make copies of these things, you guys, I'm telling you, and put them up somewhere else other than where you live, if you can, if you know somebody else that you trust with these things, that you make and leave them a copies of these things. I'm telling y'all, because things are just happening back to back to back to back. And it would just, you know, you'll be the wiser to just have a plan set in place, have something stored up. If it's not money, that'd be food, water, another place where you can go to where there's a high source of water, a lake, a river, somewhere where you can go, some water purification tablets, or a way of purifying your water, whether it be a Berkeley or whatever kind of source you may think is best for you to purify your water. If you have your vehicles, make sure it's always stay full of gas if you can. That's a lot of way a lot of us get out the cities, you know, with these vehicles, or wherever area you are in. You know, make sure you have an oil change, make sure you're checking everything and everything is up to par with your vehicle if you can, y'all, because things are just happening. I'm talking about they're just happening. I had a situation where I had to fly down south real quick, and I couldn't get a flight that same day where this situation occurred, and I had to wait the next day. But me having to just get a plane ticket all of a sudden like that cost a lot of money. I mean, a lot of money. And that was just for one way. And then I had to get back. So I'm telling you, y'all, I mean, it's just unbelievable these times that we are living in. So have an emergency plan put in place. I'm telling you, because things are happening unexpectedly. Have an emergency plan for your children. Talk to your family about the plan. So everybody, just in case you're one place and your family's another place, you guys have a meeting spot where you all can meet up at, or if the phone lines go down and the grid goes down and God forbid you can't contact people with your phone, everybody will know what to do, where to go, you know what I'm saying, and things of that nature. I just wanted to share that with you guys because it's been going on like that. Stay vigilant, stay watching, keep surviving. SanHerald.com.